Hello everyone. So in this video, I'm going to discuss how you can create the branch and how you can navigate among the different branches. So I'm going to open my user profile terminal, and in order to create the branch, I will issue following command: git checkout hyphen b and the name of the branch. So the command is git checkout hyphen b name of the branch. So this is the general pattern which people use for creating the branch, that is feature slash name of the branch. Now the moment I hit enter, it is going to create a branch, and also it is going to make this branch as an active branch on my local repository. So you can see here we got the message saying switch to the new branch. In order to get the list of the branch, just issue the command git branch. So as you can see here, in my local repository, there are two branches. One is the master and second one is the newly created branch. And currently that branch is active. That means whatever the code change I'm going to do, it will go inside this branch, not in the master. So I'm going to open the workspace of my user profile and let me add a new file here. And let me call it as user profile underscore branch. I will navigate back to the terminal, issue the command git status to know what are the file which got modified, git add, then git commit, and then git push. So you can see here, the moment I issue the command git push, we are getting an error. And it says that the current branch, the branch name, has no upstream branch. That means when we created this branch got created locally. This branch is not present on the online repository. So when I issue the git push command, the git does not know where to push the added file in the online repository. So Git has given a suggestion that we need to issue this command so that it will create an online repository and also map our local repository branch to the online repository branch. So this command is going to create the same branch in the online repository. You can see in the message new branch and the name of the branch. So this is the name of the branch which is in the local repository, and this is the name of the branch which is in the remote repository. Let me open the remote repository. And here I'm going to just do a refresh. And from this tab, if I click, you can see this is the master and this is the branch which we just created. So let me navigate back to the user profile workspace. You see, this is the file which we just added inside our branch. But if I go to the online repository and select the branch as master, I don't see that file. And let me switch to the branch. And this is the file. So this clarifies that the branch and the master, these are the two independent line of development. So whatever the code I'm going to push inside the branch, that will not go inside the master. So let me switch back to the master. So in order to switch to the master, issue this command. So git branch to get the list of branch, and then git checkout, followed by the name of the branch. So using the git checkout command, you can navigate among the branches. So as you can see here, the moment I switch to the master, you can see here master is highlighted. The moment I switch to the master, as you can see here in our workspace, the newly added file disappear. It doesn't mean it got deleted. It's just saying that currently you are on the different branch. If I want to switch back to my previous branch, just issue this command git checkout. Either you can use the name of the branch or you can use the hyphen. So it is going to switch back to the previous branch. And you can see here the file appears. So in this similar manner, I will navigate to the payment gateway terminal and create the branch from there. So currently there is only one branch which is present, that is master. In order to create the branch, I will issue the command, that is get checkout hyphen b and the name of the branch. I will navigate back to the workspace of the payment gateway team, and here I'm going to add a file. So I'm going to push this file inside the branch. Git status, git add followed by the name of the file, git commit with message, and then git push. So as you can see here, the moment I issue the git push command, it has given me an error, and this is because the payment gateway branch is only present on my local repository, but it is not present on the online repository. So git has given me a suggestion how to create the same branch on the online repository. So I will navigate back to the online repository and just do a refresh. So you can see here now there are three branches available. First is the master, which is a default. This is the branch which is created by the payment gateway team, and this is the branch which is created by the user profile team. If I switch to the master, I will see the normal code base. If I switch to the user profile branch, I will see the code base which is modified by the user profile team, and you can see this is the file which we added. In the similar manner, if I switch to the payment gateway branch, I will see the code base which is modified by the payment gateway team. So again, I will go back to the payment gateway team terminal. I'm going to switch back to the master. So for that, I will use the command, that is git checkout master. So master is our core line of development, and these are the two branches which is created from the master. Okay. Now assume that user profile team want to switch on the branch which is created by the payment gateway team. So for that, first I'm going to switch back to the master. Git checkout master. Then I'm going to issue the command, that is git pull. So the reason why I issue this command, so that it can download all the metadata about the newly created branch from the master. You can see here, it has given the information about the new branch. Now if I want to switch to this branch, I just need to do git checkout and the name of the branch. And then I will issue git branch. So I have three line of development. One is the master, second one is the user profile branch, and third one is the payment gateway branch. And currently the branch which is active is payment gateway. So if I go back to the workspace of the user profile, you can see here, this is the file which is pushed by the payment gateway team. So this is how you create the branches and switch among the branches. Now let's say I want to delete a branch. So if I want to delete a branch, first I need to make that branch inactive. Currently, from the user profile terminal, I see this branch is active. So I'm going to check out the master and then issue this command to delete the branch. That is git branch hyphen capital D followed by the name of the branch. So this is going to delete the branch. Now this branch is been deleted from your local repository. It will be still available on the online repository. So until unless it is deleted from the online repository, the branch will exist. So in this manner, you can create, delete, and switch among the branches.